the experience today. Just a quick show of hands, who has seen Pane present before? Yeah? Maybe half, third, yeah? Three-fifths? So those who have not seen Pane present before, just a fair warning, there is a lot of content. A lot, and I'll keep going, a lot of content. So, how do you cope? You don't blink. Because quite often, having done these sort of events or events in human performance, personal growth, potential for many, many years, when I first met Pane, when we presented, not together, but both at the same conference last year at the Paradigm Shift Summit on the Gold Coast, I was immediately struck with Pane's attention to detail, the level of depth, the level of confidence, and most importantly, his conviction and commitment to this area of research, personal exploration over the last 30 years. And so whether it was divine guidance or whatever it is, I just said after the event, I'll connect with that guy and we'll have a chat, and here we are today. So I'll do a little bit of a backstory on Pane for those of you who have not experienced Pane's work before. As I said, keep your eyes relaxed. Not fixed on the screen, but relaxed, because from a conscious mind perspective, you can only receive and consciously be aware of a few million pieces of information a day. Your subconscious mind receives billions and billions of pieces of information every day, and it goes into your subconscious mind. So you're here because you feel connected in some way or in all ways to this information, whether you're a personal contactee, whether you're on a personal or spiritual conscious journey yourself. I can see, you know, the average age is not 12 to 18 in the room. So there is a... there's life experience, and with life experience comes a little bit of know-how. And with that know-how, using the tools and the information that Pane is going to share with you today, you can change your life. You can evolve at a much more rapid rate, and that's what we're here for. And that's why the title of the event is The Big Picture of Evolution, of the Evolution of Human Consciousness. Because that's where we're going. And the Great Awakening is well and truly upon us. You'll see from global events, you'll see from media disclosure, undisclosure. You can hear in the very being and feel in the very being of people all around the world that there's a real hunger for change, and the change is upon us. It's not coming, it's already here. And so when we think about dimensionality, we think about third, fourth, fifth, and plus dimensions, it's not that we need to jump in a hovercraft or in a light vehicle. We are that, okay? And so the information that Pane is going to share with you in three specific chunks throughout today is going to move you from the ancient past, revealing our ties to the ancient Lemurian cultures, right into present day and where we are headed as a conscious community, okay? Global citizens or galactic citizens. So let me just do a little bit of reading. About Pane, you ready? Got cotton mouth just thinking about it. So among many other things, Pane, Astral Walker Andov, is an author, publisher, public speaker, remote viewer. He's an astral traveler, instructor of the psionic arts, and a contactee of a rare type. As you will soon discover, his knowledge and in-depth research about what we truly are, what we're capable of, and the power, the purpose of all existence, about the hidden reality that we are all a part of, the ways how we can improve our current human condition, and how we can establish contact with positive extraterrestrial species, how the evolution of human consciousness will take place, and how we can prepare and assist in the process. That's the key, how we can assist in the process. It's not down to one person. And about many other related areas as well, goes way beyond the limits of average human understanding. And you'll get an appreciation of that, okay? Because there's just so much information. So with 30 years of experience behind him and thousands of students worldwide, He had brought valuable information about the parallel worlds, what lies out there, and what to expect, what to do and what not to do on the astral plane. What not to do on the astral plane. In his recent published books, The Awakening, which are available here for purchase, volumes 1 and 3, and you can do those in the breaks. In his recently published books, The Awakening, he gave the entire humanity a beautiful gift, how each one of us can tune into altered states of consciousness, how each one of us, and depart the physical host and visit the immaterial part of the universe and find a purpose for your own existence. Pane's extensive out-of-body experiences, while he was in the best form, while he's in the best form, that's I like that, lasted over 8 hours, which led to direct contact with non-human intelligence. The contacts became frequent, and he practically underwent a teaching about the world we are living in from complex, from completely different teachers. Pane was shown what the complex messages embedded in crop circles means, and based on those contacts, he decoded more than 250 crop circles and crop circle diagrams, which he'll go through today as well. Okay, there's. You may have heard that the truth is hidden in plain sight. So learn as much as you can and then do your best to apply that knowledge to your world. That's the key. That's what we're here. So his approach about this subject is unique, and so far nothing similar has been observed or achieved anywhere else in the world. It is sad to announce, though, after 3 decades, 30 years in this space, this will be Pane's last public appearance.
Oh no!
So he's going out with a bang. And he's got the best people to help leverage that as well. Good. So today he is with us, and he will share so much information about, as I mentioned previously, our ancient, forgotten past, our present, and our future, from the times of our glorious Lemuria, and the involvement of extraterrestrial beings in the ancient times to the modern era, the hidden reality in our solar system, that's really interesting, and the glorious future that lies ahead of us. Please welcome Pane Andov.
Appreciate your kind words. Thank you everyone for coming. And we have a long day in front of us, and I have a lot of information to share, so better start. So we'll try to stick to the schedule as much as possible. So we will do the first part from 10 to 12. We'll make a 30 minutes break. And then another 2 parts, where I will actually conclude the material which is needed. So as every other talk that I have done in my life, this is just information purposes only. So whatever is going to be shared with you guys is just my personal experience and understanding of the hidden reality that we are all part of. So when we go outside and we look at our society nowadays, we are pretty much confused. We don't know how things actually got in this state, you know, and pretty much we wonder what is this place that we call universe. So the fundamental questions like who I am, where did I come from, what I'm doing here and where I'm going are bothering every each of us. So I've been into this journey for a very long time, and I found really good answers to those questions. So please allow me today to share my understanding and what I consider that there are some missing pieces in the puzzle that we are actually need to understand, so we can see the big picture in more clarity, if you will. So today I will be talking about many things. First I will address certain things that we need to be aware of, we need to improve, and what the situation is, and then I will actually take you back in time to the ancient civilizations and from what I was shown, and just chronologically go back, actually go towards the future, to the present time and to the current situation which is happening. So since you're here, it's crystal clear that we are not alone in the universe. And considering how huge and how vast the universe is, we are only one species or probably trillions of species that exist out there. So comparing the fact that those species are a lot longer in the universe, if you will, their technological capabilities and spiritual evolvement is far more greater than ours. So I will just quickly share how it all started for me, if you will. So I was born in 1973 in Macedonia, in Skopje, and from there everything actually took a strange path after a, how should I put it, event that took to it. I was only 7 and then I started to train these arts. I become one of probably best astral travelers in the world at the time. And this is the place where the first contact actually appeared, and this actually in 2018, together with my family, we back to Macedonia. We were seeing just the place where everything actually happened. At the time I was living with my mother and my brother, and my brother, he used to train martial arts, and he used to actually go to very close to the river nearby, and sometimes he was actually taking me with him. And one evening there was a strange occurrence very close to the full moon, and it was a glowing orb of light, if you will, emanating orange, yellow, red, pulsating light. And when I asked my brother how come there could be two moons, I didn't get any response. But after a few seconds, I actually looked at to him, and he was just staring into the plasma fire that was approaching literally very fast. When it got to the distance of about 50 meters, it started to ignite very fast, and there was a flash, a white flash. And the only thing that I remember was the difficulty of breathing and weightless. Actually, like gravity was completely cut off. For a few moments it was like that, and then all of a sudden the dead whiteness started to disappear, if you will, started to become more clear. You can just imagine, you know, 7 years old boy when seeing silhouettes, recognizing that those silhouettes are not human, if you will. Everything inside the spaceship, if you will, was different. It was made of some form of densic plastic, if you will. There were no hardware or no wires, no keyboards, no screens. Everything they actually controlled in a certain way through their minds, and they can actually put the holographic screens and similar things and control and get the data and readings, whatever they are doing. But they said clearly in Macedonian language that not to be afraid, that they are not here to hurt me, but they want to just do certain tests, if you will. And I was actually taken into one chamber, if you will, and then one of the beings. Regarding to the beings, they were with four fingers, you know, very, very tall. Some have a different structure, for example, it's like a vibratory elongation, if you will. Their eyes were changing. Sometimes they were black, sometimes they were white, sometimes like a neon light, like a green neon light. It all depends what they were doing. In example, sometimes when certain type of radiation bothers them, they put the black. When they're utilizing the psionic force, they start to glow, you know. When they're doing certain stuff with their super advanced brains, if you will, you know, the color of the eyes also change. But nevertheless, I actually was, I lie down on a certain platform, if you will, and then a certain radiation was applied to me, and I didn't feel any pain. It was just like a warmer or colder sensations, but in later actually time, I understood that what they were actually doing, they were scanning my DNA signature. So regarding to the DNA signature, I'm not referring physical DNA, I'm talking about a storage, if you will, of information that exists into our immaterial part of the DNA, which stays with the pure essence or the consciousness, whatever incarnation or whatever body it takes, you know, it just remains. So they were looking for certain qualities, certain profit, so a certain, how should I put it, abilities or certain aspiration, so to speak, you know. And then from there, the sensation stop on all over the body, and they move to the brain, to the right part of the brain. And that's when I started to feel that they are literally rewriting my part of the brain, and they're putting some small device, because as soon as they put that small device, I was able to register them very, very, very clearly, much, much clearer than before. And then it all took from there. For you who are not familiar, there are three types of implants, if you will. One is metallic, other one is non-metallic, and the third one is biological. the one that it was placed inside my head, if you will, it was biological, and the new pathways to the object and out of the objects were created. And I fully utilized this implant, if you will. Many people complain, I said, look, I have an implant, you know, and it's bad, you know, what they're gonna do. And that's very sad because they operate on the fear factor, if you will. But on the other hand, I utilized this device to profound levels. And I explained the entire encounter into my books, so you can check in them. But long story short, when they returned me, I was actually different. I started to experience, you know, that I can feel sharp objects. For example, if I come close to this, let's say, table and it's sharp corner, without touching it, something was cutting me, you know, like a sensitive auric field, if you will. And then I was able to hear voices in my head, which were the thoughts of my mother, brother, and other people at the time. But the most extraordinary thing was the so-called astral projection, or out-of-the-body experience. In other words, during the night time, they induce a certain state of sleeping paralysis, and my consciousness went up. And when I actually turned back and I saw my small physical body lying on the bed, I freaked out for one, two, three times. But I got used to it. I went through the ceiling and I started to literally observe the neighborhood from above. But quite interestingly, there was always an orb of light that was following me, if you will. What I'm doing, like babysitting, if you will. And then there was an incident that took place with my mother, and I had to actually stop doing all that stuff. So pretty much nothing strange or paranormal happened for the next 7-8 years. And then when I moved, when we went on a visit in Lepoglava in Croatia to visit my uncle, he was very, very skilled into all this stuff. And that's where I started to meditate. I started to practice Tai Chi Chuan and similar stuff, and actually they changed completely everything. And it was not just the astral contact that took place afterwards, but also in many occasions it was a physical contact, if you will, where there was a certain DNA checkup, upgrade, and similar stuff. So things that helped me in learning about the hidden reality and understanding of the big picture. So it's remote viewing observations, fifth system communication via holographic transmissions, astral traveling observations via direct astral contact, physical contact, and of course 30 years of extensive research studying various fields and aspects of life. So out of those, the astral projection was the most effective, because when I was starting, there were very short astral projections, like 15, 20 seconds, a minute or two, and my concentration broke and I had to walk up in the physical body. In time, with practice with ESP cards, I literally pushed to the point that it is 2-3 hours, and then over 8 hours when I was in top form. Literally, I was not losing consciousness for weeks and weeks. For example, physically, I was aware, and as soon as I went out to bed, like every other person will do, will just fall into darkness, or just departed my physical body, and my consciousness was fully aware. And that was a huge learning curve for me. I was observing what is happening on the astral plane, especially when I started to utilize the even higher vehicle, if you will, than the astral body, the so-called self-luminescent body. So from this place, which is called Novo Lisice, which is a suburb in Skopje, I took thousands of astral travels. I used to literally fly parallel with Boeing 47. So many other stuff, you know. Sometimes I was flying above the surface of the water, probably 2-3 max, you know, Mach 3 or Mach 4, you know. It was just amazing stuff that I was doing. And I put all those experiences into my diaries, unfortunately. As soon as we came to Australia, some people actually went through. They didn't steal anything valuable, neither mine, but they took the diary. So unfortunately, that was lost. During the astral travels, I met the positive ones, and I saw the neutral ones, but also encountered the negative ones, unfortunately. So it was a kind of a struggle since that with them, because they were not really happy what I was actually doing. And the beings that I was in contact with, and that they were protecting me, if you will, you know, they showed me a different reality, a different vision. There was so many stuff that they have shown me about the ancient past, about us, you know, what we are, and where all this is going. And thanks to the implant that was inside my brain, that make a lot easier. And every time when they were around, you know, I was starting to hear like a humming sound or a buzzing sound, and sometimes even the sleeping paralysis state appeared even in the awake state. I never had any issues with that. In only one occasion, when I was actually drinking a water, I just, you know, straight up, and then the Kundalini actually kicked in and I fall down. But that was the only part in so many years. All the rest was just a very good quality. And in a sense, there are different levels of communications. The basic level, it doesn't actually provide much, but when you go into the fifth system, which I described in my books, The Awakening, it goes very powerful. It's a lot more improved, if you will. So I'll just show you the amount of information that your brain gets when you have an implant, if you will. The communications is rarely with words, because they don't use words, they use emotions, they use holographic pictures. When you pick up emotions and holographic pictures, you are actually getting a lot more information, if you will. Like a few others out there in the world, the contacts were so persistent and they were using a certain plasma orbs, if you will, to communicate. And we use phones, mobile phones, the standard phones. They don't use that. They are so advanced that they are using plasma technology. This plasma can be actually utilized in so many ways that we can think of and that we cannot think of, if you will. And during my meditation and astral traveling, this is me just before departing the physical body, there is a huge orb which is coming. And from there are all communications that appeared. But the astral projection was the one. It was quite extraordinary. As soon as the contacts intensify to the point they start to project certain, how should I put it, geometrical diagrams. And in a sense, I started to learn the language of what they are actually trying to say. And they were talking about a special field which is forgotten. It was active in the ancient times, if you will. And they were referring about the energetic plasma field which exists around every living thing in the universe, if you will, or we, due to lack of terminology, we call it aura, if you will. And they were saying there are certain things that we can actually apply to this auric field. We can actually extend it, reshape it, and with the power of will, if you will, we can move the chi energy in a certain way and create a very something very, very powerful. So there are some few examples, you know, about some instructions. Like I said, more than 250 crop designs are decoded in my book, The Awakening Volume 3, and how the energy needs to go from one level to the second level to the third level, and why it has to be a star tetrahedron. Why tetrahedron itself? Because tetrahedron is an isolator of charge. Like in electricity, we have plus and minus. You have to have two polarities in order for the field to work. And once when the field, the first actually what appears is the germ of life, if you will, what we are actually experiencing now to some degree as a division of cells, they're referring that that this can be done astrally, if you will, on an energetic level, and that's where the potential of the DNA will reactivate. And the Kundalini awakening does play a major role, if you will. So all those, they were talking about some special fractality. Again, due to the lack of terminology, we call this vector equilibrium, especially the one on the bottom left is a 2D representation of it. And this is something special because it occurs when 64 tetrahedrons come together, which can be embedded into the so-called flower of life auric field. This geometry appears, and that's where the magic literally comes, and that's where the chi energy manifest in our dimension. They were talking about the genuine crop designs that they are making, that they are interconnected, that they are like acupuncture points, and they create like a ripples into the astral dimension, which is disrupting something which exists there for a very, very long time. And all that dynamics were completely explained. So chronologically, I started to make notes of what they were saying, and I was exampling a very, very simple system how to understand. For example, when 19 spheres come together, there are 30 petals which are generated inside. So very same like in this crop circle on the top left, which appeared in Germany in 2004. And they were talking about a flower of life field around the entire Earth, if you will, the entire planet, which will actually disrupt the negative software which exists. And from there, it was just quite amazing. Sometimes, after hours of astral traveling, I was literally staring into the ceiling, trying to process all that information that I saw, if you will. I saw what is happening in the solar system, actually, when I was in best of my form, if you will. I reached 33 light years away from here, so I really traveled a lot. I understood their protocols, their dynamics, when they appear, how many there appear. Is there any connection? Because day after day I was learning when certain lights appear on certain place and then they appear on other places and other similar stuff. And I understood that quite of the occasions, probably more than 80% of the occasions, we don't see the fine structure, we don't see the metal or the mineral or whatever the UFO is made of, but a plasma shield which pulsates around the object. And literally, the contact with the extraterrestrial, positive extraterrestrial intelligence changed me completely. It showed me a divine picture, if you will. They awake me to a point that I can only feel gratitude for all that they have done for me. And they said to me that they will do something to me that will trigger for me to experience certain things. And the experience of those certain things will actually lead to the point that I will understand those dynamics. And as soon as I understand those dynamics, I will be able to pass to other people. And that's how the process of awakening, they mentioned that should be. And that's exactly what it happened for the last. They actually opened the door to the universe for me, if you will. So in my youth, I tried my best, you know, to. I understood that the five senses are not enough to understand the bigger picture. So I started to push, you know, beyond the five senses. Hours and hours of training. It was more about adapting the consciousness to stay longer, if you will. Without those ESP cards, I would probably remain the same as most of the astral travelers, probably 20-30 minutes out of the body travel, and nothing longer, nothing more extensive. But with these ESP cards, they really change the dynamic. And it was meditation, a lot of meditation for me. And I actually experimented with the inner chi energy, experimented with the outer chi energy, and the stronger the outer chi energy is, the more you can actually stay separated from your physical host, if you will. During the years, I had thousands of students. I tried my best to transfer valuable knowledge so they will actually learn how to tune into meditative trance, to change their brain waves, and with certain dynamics, to depart the physical body and stay there longer. And in a nutshell, how it works, the ESP cards work in a certain way that when the thinking process is excluded and there's a certain type of breathing and concentration which is applied, the pineal gland starts to produce dimethyltryptamine biochemical compound, and that immediately activates the mental screen and the vision starts to come. That's the first stage of what people refer as a remote viewing. At first, those visions are just randomly. You cannot control, like someone is actually projecting a movie to you. But in time and in practice, people can be taught how to actually change that reflection of the astral space, if you will, to more closer ones, so they can pick up colors, numbers, you know, simple objects and so on and so forth, until they can actually see blindfold. And as the results come with people, they get motivated and they train, they pass the knowledge further. So it's about special gene that every one of us has, and it's called the meta gene. So during the years, I tried my best to literally reflect what I was actually seeing on the astral plane and learning. And it's been a really long journey. For over 3 years, I was the chief editor-in-chief of a magazine that really made a difference in the region when I was living at the time in Macedonia, and it was called Sixth Sense, where I literally was speaking about all the controversy. In many occasions, there was a secret police that were following us. In one occasion, they actually canceled the entire edition, if you will. When I spoke with the publishers, they said, look, people from the government came, they just stopped, and it was about the underground tunnels and bases with coordinates, with everything else, and they actually withdrew the entire edition. So my phone was typed, if you will. After spending 15 years in telecommunications, I can actually recognize. Doesn't matter, it is what it is. It was part of the journey. In 2007, I published my first book, Extraordinary Powers in Humans, where I actually described